Good evening, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here. My name is Yaniv Ashkenazi, and I'm working in the NOC in Israel. And this is the topic that I will speak on. Well, I am, like I told you, my name is Yaniv, and I'm working in the Elite Sport Department, which belongs to the NOC. And it's about 5 to 6 years that we are giving the professional support to the Israeli Handball Federation. I was a national goalkeeper in my career, and now I'm a lecturer in handball in the Wingate Academic College. So a brief background, because I'm sure that most of you, all of you, know about modern handball. Very high intensity speed and short duration movements, and which involves also explosive activities, which include sprint, jumps, blocks, throwing, turnings, etc. And I think that the ability to repeatedly perform intermittent high intensity actions throughout the game seems to be very important, especially now. And I think that I has quoted you, Susanna, it's you? This is you, okay, small world. I reported that during a match, like 825 activity changes of very short duration, between 2 to 6 seconds, and with 6 seconds intervals. So it looks like that the most or the major energy supply is mostly provided by the ATP-CP and the glycolytic pathways. Studies also show that aerobic power, like VO2 max, and aerobic fitness is important for game performance. So based on motion analysis data, there are differences in physiological performances between field positions in handball. So our research goal, and it is part of our yearly routine to monitor the players during the season, all the national teams. We try to evaluate anthropometric and physical abilities of the U20 and senior national team. In regard to playing positions, actually we trust our goals also on the Norwegian, I will show you later, Norwegian research, and we also try to compare between few field tests. The positions were goalkeeper, back and center were collected, and pivot and wing position. So all in all, we were with 35 players that were divided to these numbers. And they are, like I told you, from the U20 and senior national team. So to evaluate the physical performances, we undertake a few measurements, a few field tests. First of all, we took the anthropometrics measurements, like height, weight, and fat percents, also BMI. We did few field tests, count of movement jump, 5 meter sprint, 20 meter sprint with opto jump devices, 3,000 meter running, and two strength drills, which includes the squat, first RM, and bench pressed, first RM, one RM. And so, in addition to the physical performance that we've done with our athletics, we compare our results with the first league and national team from Norway. And this is the reference. A very brief procedure. The battery tests were started at 9 a.m., and this was the order from the anthropometric to the field test, and we finalized with 3,000 meter running, and the best results in each test were taken to further statistical analysis. Of course, I will not focus now on statistical analysis, but I would just say that ANOVA test was to determine the differences between the players, between the positions, and in each position. So the anthropometric measurements, as you can see, our players were young, almost 21 years old in average. The height was almost 185, and the weight was 85, almost 86, and the BMI 25.16, and the fat percents, the average fat percents was 14.51. And I will show you just the results now. And as you can see, it's divided, of course, to field positions. And you can see very, very clear that the wing position will lead the other positions in 5 meters, 20 meters, counter movement jump, and 3,000 meter. When we are going to strength drills, the pivots, and it also in the literature, in other researches, the pivots were lead this drill. And but when we doing the relative, we are trying to do it relative to the body weight. You can see that the wing position, they are the strongest relative to the body weight. You know, it also was significant. And the bench press, and again, the pivot lead the team. But again, when it's relative to the body weight, we can see that the wing were the strongest relative to the body weight. So when we trying to compare between our players to the Norwegian players, we can see clearly that the Norwegian players, the data is like that, that the number of athletes from Norway, were a lot, 174 players, 174 players comparing to 35, but I'm quite sure that this is the trend and it makes logic. Also, the differences in weight. Our players, it's like I told you, weight around 86, and it's about almost 5 kilo differences, and almost 5 centimeters differences. So it's quite a lot in these levels. And when we are going to the field test and try to compare between the Israeli national team players and the Norwich team. First of all, we can see that the Norwegian team were better, significantly better than the Israeli. But you can see the similar trend in all the field position, in all the field tests and all the strength tests, that the wing player, the wing position lead all the tests except the strength test. And of course, it makes sense from the handball point of view. The pivot position that require a lot of blocks and a lot of contacts in defense and also, of course, in offense make it very logic that they will be the strongest player, the heaviest player, comparing the other positions. And if you're going to the conclusion, I will give you more details about our interpretation. So our research provides an updating data about the anthropometric and physical abilities profile of the U20 and the national team players. And our main findings, so we found that significant differences between field position in anthropometric and measurements and physical ability tests. Like I said before, the pivots weight the most also in the Israeli national team and also in the Norwegian team. And the wing weight the least. So it makes sense because they are the fastest, and it makes sense that they will be with the least weight. In our research, like in other researches in these fields, the wings exhibit the best results in physical ability tests. Also, like I told you, in our research. And compared with the Norwegian team, national team and the first league, the Israeli U20 and senior national team presented lower results in almost any parameter tested. And based on our findings, it's really clear that we need to increase and improve the performing additional handball-specific training, which include strength, speed, power, agility, and high-intensity aerobic training. Intermittent activity is highly recommended. We think that our results, because we think that we didn't invent we researched or gave you the new advertisement, because it's not something new, but we think that we can help the SNC coach with creating an updated physical ability test result standard in accordance with field positions. And we think that we can also help with selection players into field positions and also in the field, practically in practice, maybe to divide the team and spread the team to field position and work specifically on their demands according to the data we achieved and also published in the literature. So I just want to show you a few data that we collected during the season, and we're trying to apply and implement this data for practical solutions and to do it better, and that's it.